So where was I? Let's get back to. Oh, let's just first. Right. Let's just boot up this, or let's just log in. We have a time of 15:25. And there you have that stupid SE alert. 15:25, so our search. ABC TS 15:25 audit to allow. And then less that. So if all went well, we're just stuck with a lot of home files. But actually, every time something new pops up, example, they had that one. Grab. The mom grab execute. It's running Python, so that's fine. But anyways, we need to basically allow some stuff for the mom. This first rule and the random. They the mom. PNT and this one. And then let's go back and see what else we have. Gdoc search P needs to be the prop. And also wants to be its own executable file. Gdoc search proc gdoc search p. I'll add that here because this can be appended to the, and you'll see that eventually every app needs to be able to search its own executable, read its own executable file. It's always the case. Shell executing file. Let's see what that is. T shell. Oh yeah, that's that event stuff. We can ignore that. We should label even though. Maybe we should just do that right now. Events. Let's just do the basics. Then just edit the policy and then allow clone shell, as it G shell, yeah, and allow clone shell to actually check whether it's executable, I guess. So that's basically allow of don't audit my login user t g shell t events exec t file execute, and I'll make that test, and then just allow audit access. We have Cdoc search P, we already took care of that, I guess. This is the Pinty for Gnome Shell. And the remainder seems pretty much. Oh, yeah, that's the login user. So, what I'm wondering is. Let's just try it out. If I run a program, then what actually, who actually runs that? So let's run gedit and then just I'll search mavcts1534 grep execute, and it's actually GNOME Shell running it. not that it matters. But it's just weird. It just looks weird. So actually, factually, this latest rule for that don't audit for certain shell doesn't really make sense, because eventually you'll have to be able to run it. But still, I'll just keep it. Alright, so let's just forget about that stuff for now. Let's just go and grab for execute. Grab for create. And then less that. Let's see what happens. Let's see what's happening here. So basically any let's take a good look at this. It seems I'm not getting all the information I'd like, but I know that XDG UDIR update is creating these DIRs. So let's just take care of that. Let's just take care of that. So we have, let's just take care of that. XDGU there. So let's just take care of that. So we have a file, transition, and then it's this guy, and then user home dir, and it's dir, and then user home t, and then that's for these guys. And then there's a bunch of them. My login user. So we have desktop documents. I'll just copy this over to the screen. So desktop, documents, downloads. This all needs to be generic. Music. Pictures. Public. Templates and video. Templates. Video. These need to be generic. Then let's just allow user home and then it's basically the, and then add name. That's one thing I know that's needed. And then user home to the create. Those are two things that I know are needed. Now, there's more, because what else? Oh yeah, this user does user ID. This is created. Local, this one. So GNOME keyring daemon needs to create the local dir, and the local dir currently is ls-all-home-dominic. Grab local. Gconf home to, it's not a name I would choose, but okay. So GNOME keyring daemon is all the way on top, and he ain't the only one that needs to be able to create that. So require type gconf home, and then it's basically type transition and copy this one, user home the and then it's gconf home key, but only for local. Then we'll need to allow user home the add name, and then create for gconf home t. Gconf home t. That should make that work. Okay, what else do we have? New session there, but I don't know where. P- Pulse cookie. Let's have a look. Crap. Pulse. Pulse Audio Home T. So all these three. Pulse Audio, Pulse Cookie. This is the. It's all Pulse Audio. Pulse Audio, and that ESD out. I don't know. Can't see that right now. So let's take care of that. Pulse Audio. So require type Pulse Audio Home Key, I guess that it was. And then this type transition Pulse Audio. User home dir T, and then there's this file, this Pulse Cookie, Pulse Audio Home T, and then it's Pulse Cookie, and then we have a similar for Pulse, but it's there. Am I right? Pulse Cookie file there, yeah. And then we have that ESD out, but I'm not sure what creates that. But I can basically, no, I'm not going to make any assumptions. So Pulse is a dir and Pulse Cookie is a file. So now we need to allow user home dir T, and then for the dir it's basically add name, and then for their Pulse Audio there, Pulse Audio Home Key under create. But we need to do this also for the file. Let's take care of that. I have this auto spawn, but I don't actually see it executing it. And then here is that these settings data convert. Let's see what else we have. See if we have something. User temp T, GNOME settings daemon. So let's run user. Oh, actually it's a file, yeah. Kind of hard. PA control is actually creating that shared memory file. So we'll basically need to create a new type, or we already had that type, probably. Tough. Let's first just deal with this. Don't get ahead. Get ahead of ourselves. Step by step. And then just log out, and then log out at 15:51. Let's see if we have any ABC now at 15:51. We might be able to add audit to allow less. Not really. These are all okay. Kill all and then clear. So now we're at 50:52. LS all home login my login user and we have this cache that we cache in public. So let's just edit our script. Public and cache. Right. Run that again. And then let's see, do we have ABC denials? No, nothing. Login. Let's have a look at this. See any pools. So that something is not right there. Yeah, so the pools in the pool scoopy aren't created properly. Let's have a look at pools. Oh, did I actually install that module? Yeah, I seem to have done that. Grab pools. Yes. Make that pivot pools. Yeah, it's not, still not doing that. Why is that? Because I didn't save it. Syntax error, yeah. It's all getting done really tiresome right now. It's got to close. Syntax error, desktop. Let me guess. Oh, now I see. I forgot to remove this. I already was blaming keywords and all kinds of obscure stuff. But now I'm just making stupid typos. 21H3. All kinds of excuses for my nasty typos. There were all kinds of excuses for my nasty typos. So that was just a waste of time. That was just a waste of time. Sorry about that. That was just a waste of time. 1600. Nothing to do. 50-59. All right, let's try this again. 1600 was empty. Wrong password. Tiresome. Okay, 1600. Now we should have at least some transitions going on. So here we have PA control. Let's PACTL add that in. Do we have more? Yeah, we have here. Dconf is created properly, I see. Audio. Use home dirty right. And it's trying to create another file there. Pulse audio. Pulse audio. Break right now. Nope, no break for you. So, pulse audio dir. Pulse audio foul. There's a link file as well there, and then it needs to write. Alright. Then it's actually also creating a file, so we need to basically grab the pulse audio and then file and create, and see what that file is. So, grab pulse audio, grab. Create grab file. I would have sworn these are the t grab file tools audio. It's actually creating ICE authority, seems. And here it's what's happening here. ESD out is created here by Tools Audio, so we have it, we have him. So here we have another one, of course. Messing up again. File. And that's ESD out. And it also needs to unlink that. Do you see? Unlink, create, oh, lock. Okay, what else do we have? What creates ICE authority C, and that's in user 100T, no session, ICE authority, grab create. Videos. We've got the videos for XDG update, I guess. And then we have these GTK bookmarks created. And that's just a file, so let's just call this anything needs to be able to create these bookmarks. That's really, that sucks. The same goes for ICE authority, I think. So we need to basically create a file, GTK bookmarks, the file type. New type GTK bookmarks, and then type GTK home T. I don't know what to call it. GTK home T, and then basically make it a file type. GTK home T, and also make that a user home type. User home type. And then just basically also in the file context file create a home dir, and then GTK bookmark. System U object R G G2K home T and 0, something like that. G2K bookmarks, isn't it? Yeah, G2K bookmarks. And then this basically allow ACG to create that. So that's a type transition. User home the T file. Is it actually created there? LS home my login user. Let's there, yeah. G2K bookmarks. File and then G2K home T and then just leave it there. And then GTK home to GTK home to, and that file needs to be created. So yeah, that seems to be fine. Now we have the ISO authority. This is created by a new session. And it's all set. Yes, ISO authority. ISO out home to. Okay, and that's created by GNU session. So GNU session. Where are you? Damn it. GNU session. So let's just put that here. Require this type. Make sure that it's created properly. Type transition T session and then user home dirt T. And then it's a file, and it's called iceout.c, and then we can use a file type, a file name transition. Yeah. So iceout home key, and then we give that a name. Iceout. And then we basically need to allow. User home the T after, and then it's basically right at 9. And then basically also allow this same mother ice out home t file and create that. This is basically how we're dealing with these type transitions. Steadily. Here we have other stuff. Name session, zone. This is all stuff inside. Other doors. We need to make sure that the top level is done properly first. So this is all stuff in dconf. Let's see what we have here. Not what I'd like to see. I was looking for a share, local share, but that's not in this list right now. User tempty, or let's just do tempty first. Audio creating a file in temp. Let's just make it a little bit cleaner. This. That ESD is a temp, is a is this one here, and it's actually dir, right? It's a dir, so we need to basically allow Pulse Audio to create dirs in temp. Pulse Audio, and of course, oh, we're lucky. We're lucky. So we're having a type transition. We're saying there's Pulse Audio temp key, I guess it is. Pulse Audio temp key. Pulse Audio. Empty should already exist. This transition, so then we get allow. Let's see how this copy this. To write an add name to temp leaders so that it can actually add that to slash temp, and then temp t, and that's just create for now. And that should take care of depth. I guess. Well, that socket is inside the door. MCP is also creating stuff, but that's probably okay. Let's keep it like this for now because we need to basically have a clear overview. And of course, first let's fix the bugs. User home type. We need to require that before we can use it. Require attribute user home type. And then try again. Temp T. Same deal. Temp T, and that's so I'll just there's so many temp stuff. Require that here. Type temp T. We have an unknown type. Ouch. So that type doesn't even exist. So we're gonna make it exist. Where is pools audio temp T? Type pools audio temp T, and then type attribute pools audio temp T. User temp type, and then also temp file, temp file, and also make it file type. File type. But we need to require some stuff right now. We need to require that attribute temp file, but also user temp type, if that even exists. That seems to be it. Type attribute. Errors. Boots audio temp T, and I'm just not closing shit down. And now it's building. I'm loading that up. And I need to make sure that I clear temp so that I can see what actually it creates. And then basically I need to make sure that the top level content is labeled properly, and as much as possible the same as Fedora, because else we're gonna get into conflict and then add other stuff. So logout. Right, then kill the pros, kill that stuff, kill all, then clear. And then go to our ls temp, and then just ls temp, I mean. And then just basically rm rs shitload of stuff there that I need to get rid of. I wonder what creates this stuff. Might be these settings. Okay, 16:25. Audit to allow. Yes. Yeah, well, less, I mean. Okay. Whatever. What do we have currently? A 28. Nothing. So let's just log in. It's also painstaking work, these type transitions, these file type transitions. But yeah, part of the job. Canberra. Where is Canberra? Canberra wants to interact with Pulse Audio home content, and that's okay. For some reason, cache gets created properly. Settings. give me a break. It's, I'm not gonna get a break here. Oh, I do. Ain't that about a bitch? Shell. Let's do that. I'm not going to search for the gnome shell. Damn. That's basically the ESD out file, probably. So we have Naut reading the GTK bookmarks. Naut. Pulse Audio needs to create that link file. Pulse Audio. T. That might get me there. So it's a create that link file here. We have XTG home key. XTG, you dare update. And then where's that file getting created? So basically what it needs to do here is it needs to add some stuff, right? But what creates grep temp t grep create, because what creates that pulls audio stuff? I thought I'd actually created. Pulse audio temp T. Yeah, that's wrong. That was wrong. So that's why it didn't work. That's how you figure out bugs. Do we have, what the hell do we have more? So for some reason, my cache gets created properly. And it's all that home, my login, user. So for some reason the cache gets created proper. Don't ask me why. So what's in cache? Let's see if we can. So here we have a lot of stuff. So let's grab cache empty, cache empty, and then so IAM settings is creating IAM settings. So let's insert the where is imsetd? So we have this type, so let's just create a new type, type imsetd or cache empty, and then type attribute imsetd cache home d, and that's a file type, but it's also a user home type. And we should probably also classify the user cache home type. So what we're getting here is type transition, and then that stupid imset type, cache empty, and I'll just require that. There, yeah. Require type cache empty. And then basically we're going to insert the cache home t, but only on, and what's that called, in settings. But that requires us to basically cache home t dirs, to basically write and add name to those dirs. Add name. Name. And then it also requires us to obviously create IAM set the cache home t. I am said the cache home t dirs. Okay, that should take care of that. Let's have a look at something else. So inside there probably it creates a log file, but so here we have a tracker which is created by tracker store, tr store, and it's a dir. So it's the same drill. TR store. It's the same deal here. Basically, type TR store cache home T, and then type attribute, and it's a TR store. TR store cache home t, and it's a file type, but it's also a user home type. And then we can allow the type transition to happen. So what you get in here is a type transition from this stupid domain to type transition from cache home t, and it's a dir, and then it's tr store cache home t. Oh, and actually we need to also take care of the file context. So before I'm going any further after this one, I'm going to take care of that. Cash home key duh, and we need to basically write to it and add name to it. And then we also need to, and I'll just copy this over, create dirs that are the store cash home key. Okay, and then basically we need to go to the file context file, and then we have these cache tracker, and everything in there, and it's tr store cache home key, and then there's another one, and that's that inset stuff, inset the home cache home key, and that was in settings. So those are at least two of them there. Okay, let's have a look. What else do we have? Abort. So abort applet is creating that abort stuff. So it's the same drill. So let's just do the abort here first. ABRT, and I'll call it abort cache home key. ABRT cache home key. Save and exit that. TR, and then just go for ABRT Apple. And then just create a new type there. Type ABRT cache home T, and then type attribute and then ABRT cache home T, and then make that a file type, but also make that a user home type. And then basic call lolly, add a rule, type transition rule, leave it here, transition, then that stupid type, cache home key, dir, and ABRT cache home key, and then make that ABRT, and then close that, and then this allow stupid type cache home T dir write at name. And then just copy that over, and then do the same button for create for the ABRT cache ID. And let's take out that. Let's have a look at some more. So we have abort, and then inside there, and we have the event sound cache, which is created by Canberra. But let's take care of evolution first. Evo source registry create evolution. So go to the FC file. Evolution. Evolution. Revolution, bit long name, but and then same here, and it's Evolution Cache. T type attribute Evolution Cache. T, and it's a file path, and it's a user home. Transition, cache home T, the evolution cache home T, and then it's evolution. Okay, let's make sure that it can actually add an dir entry. Allow, and then cache home T dir, write to it and add a name to it, and also then allow it to create the evolution cache home create. Evolution cache. Let's go ahead and see what else we have. Fox, which is created by Gcon search provider, so we copy that. Fox, actually we don't copy that. Oops. I guess. Gcon. Search. P. Okay. Add a type. Type. Contacts. Cache home T type attribute. A lot of work. Contacts cache home. A lot of typing. I should have copied it. Copy that stuff. Because every word I type there's a typo. Cache T dir, and then it's contacts cache T, and then it's Fox. Right, allow cache home T dir, right, add name, and then create that. And then we have TDM, but TDM seems to for some reason already created automatically. So event sounds cache is created. So this is actually a file and directly in cache. Here it is. And it's created by Canberra event sound. So I'll call that ESC. And this is actually a file. And it's still some cache. And I'll just do it like that. And now ESC. ESC cache D. And then just go to T and then it's Canberra. Canberra. Type here, type ESC cache home T type attribute ESC cache home key, and it's a file type, but it's also a user home type, and then basically create a type transition. And the shitty thing here is that we cannot use a named file transition. So we type transition, and then it's the Canberra type, and then it's cache home key file, and then it's ESC. Then allow this mother cache home T file there the right at name, and then this is actually file create file ESC cache home key. Let's see if this builds. Most likely not. You know how we do it. It's not declared. Require it here. Line 666, we have a syntax error. We didn't close that. That's all these bugs. Load that up. it step by step. I'm not doing it too much, going too far. So it seems that my login user is still created with the wrong type. Let's see if we can also fix that. Actually, oh, that basically was due to an error. Yeah. So we loaded it up. Let's just keep our cool. And log out. And right about now, GDM should crap out. No, it doesn't. Not sure why. So now we're killing, then we're clearing all, and then we're ls temp, ls all temp, and create that crappy div that we rm. And I'll search ABCTS 16 57 audit to allow, and then let's stop, see what we have. Looks oh, here, login D, this one we can add. Login D. We should actually GVFS 10D. We should move this somewhere else. Doesn't belong here, obviously. But just so that we can get rid of that. That was basically all. So I'll search 5.9. Let's see if we're clean. And we're clean. Let's log in. And it's getting way late now. But I'm on a roll, kind of. There's a lot of work to be done. There's a lot of directories to be created. So now we'll see probably a lot of different types. So here we have abort. So we can add that to abort. ABRT cache home key. Let's just temporarily paste that here, and then just use that to adjust. Basically, this can be appended. So it's actually creating a dir inside that stuff. And then basically, this file. Put that on ABRT, and it also wants to get at you with cash, though. So that's something I will also take care of this. So it's get attribute cache, get attribute cache, and then also just require type home routine and get rid of that. Yep. We have this stuff that we can ignore for now. We have Canberra doing the dance. Where is Canberra? And that's ESC cache home to Canberra. Where are you? Here you are. So let's paste that in. Oh, paste, I mean. Then that file needs to be expanded a bit, and then we can remove this one. What's next? Evolution. Evo. Evo address factory. Evo address. And it needs to also search, because else it can never ever get to there. So it's because this is cache evolution. Where are we? And here we also have EvoCalf, same deal. EvoCalf all the way down. And make that also search. That's EvoCalf. And then here we have a bunch of this is Evo Address Factory. Evo Address. And that's basically no. Evo Source Ranch. Evo Source. Space is here for now. So we have cache empty, which also needs a get attribute. And then we have this for the so it actually creates a file in there. But it's not, that's not visible yet. Contacts, so that's contacts cache empty. Contacts cache home. See, place it in here. And it's get attribute. And on that dir here, it wants to write and also add names, so it's creating stuff in there. Of course, you won't, else you're not going to create it there and not create anything in there, of course. So we have GJS console. GJS console, and that's actually acting on checker store. But it can only do so can get to it. What else do we have? We have G session acting on ice out. G session. Oops. And we have finally some G-set stuff. But it also needs a search stem to get there. And actually it needs to probably also search, but okay, first things first. Audio empty. Oh, and also needs to get attribute of homebrew tree, that's obvious. Now shell needs to a bunch of stuff. D-shell, and D-shell is after this, I think. So what it does is this can be removed. Oops, this can be removed, but this stuff needs to stay. And we have this stuff here for IM set B. IM set B. add that on top here, and then basically on the dir, and that's the inkset dir itself, and then this one can be added there. Now we can remove these two. Yep, that seems fair. We have Pulse Audio PA control working on Pulse Audio. PA CTL. And that's Pulse Audio temp. So it needs to search temp as well. Else you can get to it. But it, and then Pulse Audio itself. Oh, and also that Homebrew 2, did I add that? No, I didn't. I need to do that first. Now I need to take care of Pulse Audio. Pulse Audio. See, let's just add it here, and let's see the stamp stuff though. Actually, so this doesn't belong here. Let's go here. So what do we have? We have stamp. That in, and then we have a file and a sock file actually. But obviously it also needs to search temp. For T minor, TR minor FS, I should just put that above the okay, so I'm too sure, yeah, that should be it. So that's TR, and right, remove name, it's dead. Actually deleting, let's just grab a lot of stuff there. User does remove name user does, yeah. Ah, oh, here it is in config. But config still ain't labeled properly. So we can't really get to that. Config is actually use arm key. So that same stuff that we're dealing with. I still don't know what creates conf. See, there's no outlet of that. So I'm just gonna have to be patient, and I'm gonna also basically quit this episode because I'm been taking too long already, I guess. But we're advancing slowly but surely, but there's a whole lot of stuff still to do. Really though. Log out. Are we hanging today now? Yep. Audit to allow. Let's see what we have. This stuff needs to be appended. Inset D. And then just add that here. And then just see what we have, cache. So we need to search cache, obviously. And then there's this file, and it needs to get attribute, open, and append. But we already have that. For some reason, that wasn't applicable. What do we have? Pulse audio. Okay. And pulse audio. With regard to temp, I think, wasn't it? So we have this home root. That's this. Add that. this stuff. So for the right remove name get attribute, we already have that. For a file, write unlink open, write unlink open, and for soft unlink, and we don't have that. Unlink. Then we have track store, track minor, tr minor FS. Where is tr minor FS? Yeah, just base it and say for the actually have a bunch of stuff here. Weird. And for file we have rename. So we do have open, we have write, we have get attribute, and we have read. So this is basically lock. And then we have the TR store which wants to lock. TR store. Wants to lock the file. Also needs to search obviously, but it's locking actually the file, so this is not a file created by himself, but anyways. And we have a syntax error at 2000. And what may that syntax error be? I see it. So at 2072, we are not closing it properly. And we have a set attribute on sock file at 1325. Set attribute on sock file, where is that sock file here? So I'll just class sock file get attributes, oh set attribute, damn. set attribute, not get attribute. Install. And we're almost done. Did I log out? Yeah, I did log out. So I'll just clean up the dirt, kill any existing remaining processes. And then ls all z temp. And let's get rid of this pulse audio. RMRF temp. And we'll leave it at that.